Right, it's a chilly Monday morning. So the last video is me taking off the roof of the other extension. So today, like I said, we'll start taking this down. So what I'll do is I'll do a before and after. We'll get that roof off and then I'll start taking the windows out of both extensions as well. So this is a before and this is it after. That was fairly painless getting all that off. I've now just got to deal with getting all the rafters out of the way and clean up the debris. There was so much debris on that full ceiling there, it was ridiculous. Loads of chipboard and plastic bags again, so I'll get all that bagged up, cleared up, and then we'll get these windows out. Happy days. Little update. So that's all the wood cleared away and all of the rubbish. I'm leaving all the rubble because when all these walls come down, I'll be getting the digger around and smashing this all away at the same time. So there's no point wasting effort. I've called in a favor. So one of my friends over here is a qualified plumber and he's been over here for many years. So he's familiar with the fittings. So this is the main water pipe coming in. So that the old tap on it's knackered. So what we're doing is getting a new tap, putting a temporary feed to this tap. So basically for the duration of the job, we've got water inside ready to use, makes the rest obsolete so we can rip it all out. Same out here where the original boiler is, we can make all that obsolete and get rid. So like I said, next job will now be, we'll take these windows out. So we'll take these two windows out and then we'll go into the other extension and take those windows out. We're basically just taking the whole house down. It's been said, and I'll probably say it for the whole duration, we should just knock the whole house down and start again. Right, as you can see, that's the two windows out now. Pretty much I'll wait for the digger to knock the rest of those walls down. It's no point doing it manually. Go over there now and do those windows next. Right, it's another day. I'm gonna take the windows out like I said earlier in the video. So that one, and then the one on the other side.
Can't say they're not putting well. Right, we'll get on with the other ones.
Window in.
After.
This is a before. And after. Job done.
I was getting a bit carried away. I thought I'd better see what I'm doing. So now I've cleared all this side. I'm just taking down the guttering and the soffit and the first row of tiles. So the sun's in the wrong place, it'll blind you, but I've done that and I just carry on working away along and then I'll go on the other side and do the same. But I just do a before and after, so this is what it looks like now.
This is what the other side looks like, so I just get all this side done once I finish the other side.
Right, I'm totally getting carried away. So that's all been removed, it's still weather tight. But I've taken all that, I'm just taking away the soffit along the edge. Basically anything that doesn't need to be in place, I'm getting rid of. The roof's totally coming off anyway and the whole building's going now, we've decided. So yeah, it's all demo from here on.
Okay, I've been busy in this little area. See this line? That is the floor height of the original build the whole way around that I've transferred. What's going to happen? So I've transferred it onto the other side. I'm going to cut it again and then hopefully, he says, hopefully when we get the digger and pull all this down, I'm hoping it'll just fall and leave that in place. And rather than having to build up the wall again and put shuttering in, because obviously we're raising this floor, that can be part of the retainer. Why rebuild something that's already there? So I'm hoping it'll stay in place for the sake of an hour's work. It's worth the risk. Worst case, it falls down and we have to rebuild it again. So I thought I would try it because there's no harm in trying. Let's go up on the roof. So yesterday we had a meeting with the architect. It was basically to go through the final few bits and pieces we needed to know, where the fosse septique was going, what fosse septique we would be using, where it goes, all the plans in relation to that. Final bits of paperwork. So that was all resolved and we were having a discussion and I said, look, I thought this at the beginning of the job, having, you know, looked further into it and speaking to my mate who come and helped do the plumbing, who's got a lot of experience as well, and we were chatting. As he put it, you can't polish a turd, and the house is that badly done. We've just said, would we be able to get away with ripping it down and just starting again? And he says, the architect, if we had have applied originally, probably not, but because we now have the permit to do the rebuild, basically we can, because it's been submitted, they've accepted the build. There was going to be so many alterations anyway, I don't really see how they can argue anyway. So basically, I am now going to demolish the whole building by hand. So it's nearly there anyway. I had to do so much stuff to get it back to where it was going to have to be anyway. It's really not that much. So what I'm going to do now is take all the tiles off the roof, start taking all the batten and everything, start clearing that. Get all the trusses and everything out of the way over the next couple of days, and then we'll get the digger and hopefully we'll be able to pull it down quite easily. It shouldn't be too much of a bother. There's the odd bit of reinforced concrete here and there, so I might have to get the cutter and hammers out, but yeah, it should be fairly painless. I forgot my GoPro, I'm using my iPhone, but I'm just going to carefully walk along the ridge. So here's the roof. Let's come back in a sec when it's all done. I've got to remember to look into the camera.
Right, that's the roof all stripped off. I'll now start taking the battens off and then the rafters.
Okay, that's the roof all stripped off now. I've just got to get rid of the insulation. And then we'll start taking all the beams down and smacking the gables off. Very precarious where I'm standing.
What a shit job. Right, that's that all done.
Right, that was the insulation cleared. So yeah, like I said, gable ends. Problem is these bricks are really, really thick. They're 200, so when you hit them, if they were 4 inches, they would just blow away. Instead, you've got to smack them and smack them. So it's not actually going to be that easy a job. So I'm just going to attack it now and we'll see what happens. You don't want that when you're using a sledgehammer. Right, that's that end gable all knocked down. I'm hoping, he says, hoping that the digger will then be able to reach high enough to pull the rest of it down. Not entirely convinced. Right, this one should be slightly easier because the blocks aren't as wide. So we'll get this one down now. Thank you.
That took 2.5 minutes to knock that down. Took about an hour to do that one. Right, let's clean up the mess. Not much of a roof left now. Tell you what, having this floor boarded out has made life so much better. I'm sweating underneath here again now. Right, I can't be bothered to really do this gable end, but I'm going to make a start.